Okay, so the Celtic Dead, the mission of the Celtic Dead is to promote music, an interest in music that's traditional Celtic, but it also covers a lot of other things that seafaring type songs, things like that. Now, as you can see, this is Bob Hicks, and I'm Sean Young, and we team up. We call it the Celtic Dead Music Group, and we kind of just got started on that thing, but it's so far it's going pretty good with your help and patience. as you can see, we're both old. We're living proof that there were children that survived the 1950s. So, yeah, that's true. Thank you. And it's really true, too, because, you know, when I was young in the 50s, we had to have rehearsals as we go out into the hallways in grade school and such, because there was the atomic bomb, you know. So we had to prepare for that. And so we had to either hide under the desk or we had to get out in the hallway and keep our faces down and keep our eyes closed, that type of thing. And I guess it worked, because I didn't see anybody with radiation burns when I went through school. So that's pretty good. Okay, so we play traditional instruments, and of course, the Cleghorns, they will play traditional instruments that are electrified, and so that's the kind of a transition on that thing. As you can see, Bob is playing a traditional Celtic instrument from Spain. Yes, that's true. It's called a guitar, and in Spanish, guitar means guitar. So that's what he plays. Now I'm going to be playing a little whistle to start off with. Now this is not your little plastic whistles in grade school. This is a professional whistle. It's made out of Delrin, which is made out of plastic. So it's we're going to try to do a Celtic. Alrighty. Oh, by the way, that reminds me, unlike the Cleghorns, we have an opening laser show here. Hang on just a minute. Can you see that? All right. Oh, there's nothing on. You'll remember us after that, right? Is that laser show. You'll go home and say, oh, there was a laser show. Wow. All right. We're going to do a tune called Julia Delaney. And the significance on that tune is that Delaney, or Dulaney, was the Black Knight family, and so that's how the wars began with the in Ireland and such. So it's got kind of a nice tune. A lot of people died, of course. You know, if you're playing Celtic music, everybody's got to die and that type of thing. And we're celebrating the death of a person, actually, and that's St. Patrick's Day coming up this weekend, right? So remember that we wear the green because it's a funeral color. That's in Ireland, and of course St. Patrick is the patron saint of Ireland, and he came from Wales. Okay, all right. So we're going to be kind of celebrating some of that here, and there's a lot of Celtic bands running around hoping to play the music, and that's what we're going to do. All right, Julia Delaney, you ready? Can you hear him? Is he plugged in? Just a minute. Okay, all right. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I messed them up. All right. Well, okay. So we survived that one well enough. All right. Okay. So the next instrument I'm going to play, which is a traditional Irish or Celtic tune instrument, is called the it's called the Boran. Oops. Sorry. Excuse me. Would help to turn it on. Yes, I'm electrified too. Okay, so this is made out of goat skin, and it's a drum. Looks like a drum. It is really secretly. So it's a it's called a it's spelled like this: Bodhran, and you pronounce it Bowron or Boran. Now, if you're gypsy, it would be a Boreen. And if it's small, like a little hat or a tam, it'd be a tamboreen. And if you guys think I'm joking, look it up. That's exactly what it is. So it's used a lot in Celtic music, and it's pretty versatile. Of course, Daniel, when he comes out on the Cleghorns here, he'll play the bigger version of the drums and such. But it still comes out for the basic drum. Okay, so I have a little thing here. It looks like a stick, and in Gaelic, it's a sipen or a sippen, and in Gaelic, that means stick. That's exactly what it is. And so it's used as the tipper, and they call it a tipper. So you can get several beats out of these things. And so a lot of it was used, like I said, the Celtic Dead, we cover a lot of songs, including folk and seafaring songs. So the one song we're going to wrap this thing up with, we're going to play two tonight. I know you guys wanted us to play about 15 of them, and so did the Cleghorns, but we just don't have enough time, you know, so what can I say? So we're going to do one that most everybody, but I need your help on this one. This is a group participation song. I'm supposed to warm you up for the band. It's coming in. So, okay. So you got to work with me here. I promised them I'd get you all excited. So here we go. This is answering the question that when I was in the Marine Corps, we had a lot of Navy personnel come up to us, and they kept asking me the question, especially when they come up from shore duty, as to what do you do with a drunken sailor? So... several people start asking these questions, and the answer comes in from several ways of handling this particular sailor who needs to be taken care of. So, you ready? All right, here we go. What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? You aren't singing. I'm sorry, did I not specify? It's got to be way, hey, up she rises. Isn't that right, Bob, or is it something else?
Way, hey, and up she rises.
Oh, and up she rises. Thank you. And so it's way, hey, and up she rises, way, hey, and up she rises, and way, hey, and up she rises, early in the morning. You ready? All right, one more time. What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? Early in the morning, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning. What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor early in the morning? Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey.
Put him in the hole with the captain's daughter. Put him in the hole with the captain's daughter. Put him in the hole with the captain's daughter. Early in the morning, way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Early in the morning, put him in the back of the paddy wagon. Put him in the back of the paddy wagon. Put him in the back of the paddy wagon. Early in the morning, way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Early in the morning, put him in the hole until he's sober. Put him in the hole until he's sober. Put him in the hole until he's sober. Early in the morning, way, hey, up she rises. Rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning. What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? What do you do with the drunken sailor? Early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning.
You guys did great. Great.
Oh, America. We'll be right back. Thank you. We're doing songs from our CDs, and we've got them for sale back here by the door, I believe. Is that correct?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Hey, you remember, like, an hour ago, we were up here sound checking, and it was nice and cold. You know, we were feeling good. And now there's puddles of sweat up here. I don't know what's going on.
We played in Salina, Kansas a few years ago. And the humidity was so high. I mean, we were up there. I looked around where I was standing, and there were just great big drops of sweat like silver dollars all the way around me. Good times.
All right.
What you playing, Dylan?
This here is called a didgeridoo. You can say it, it's fun to say. Didgeridoo. So this comes from Australia. It's the instrument invented by the natives there, the Aborigines.
Well, this one came from Home Depot.
Oh, yeah. Needs a paint job, too. But you may ask, what does an Australian didgeridoo have to do with Ireland and St. Patrick's Day? And the answer is, nothing. We just like how it sounds.
We just knew that there were, you know, the prison colonies there, and they dropped us all off back then.
Thank you.
This next one is called Tomorrow's Sunrise. No, we're not quite ready. This song reminded me of a story. I told this story last night, and it came back to haunt me. But I will share it with you anyway. When I was a young man, I was living in Austin, Texas. And my family was in Waco, so I was about 19 years old or so. So I headed back to Waco to visit my family on the weekend. And as I got ready to leave, my mom said, "Well, how are you really doing?" And I said, "Oh, I'm struggling, but you know, I got to be to work in the morning, so I've got to get going." And she reached in her pocket and took out a $20 bill and stuck it in my pocket. Well, at that time, that's like 50 bucks or so is now. But I said, "Mama, I'm not going to be able to pay you back here. You keep your 20." And she said, "No," and she stuck it back in my pocket. And I said, "I just don't know when I'm going to be able to pay you back." And she said, "You'll pay me back when you stick a 20 in your son's pocket." And yeah, so that was a pretty sweet memory. So I told that story last night, all heartfelt and everything, feeling good. And this is what happened.
"I'll take that 20 now." Even though it's more like 50 today, right? That's what you said?
That's what you get. I've also been accused of raising kids to make them band slaves. Seems like it's worked the other way around. Okay. I brought a clock up here, so I'm looking down kind of to see what we're doing on time. And somewhere along the way, the clock got turned upside down, so I'm really, oh, man.
Just do a handstand.
Yeah. tomorrow's sun. We're doing all original songs, by the way. So Dylan and I co-write a lot of these songs, or either one or the other writes it. And we hope you enjoy it. It's on our CDs back here. And a lot of times we will take a traditional Scottish or Irish melody of some kind and work it into our music. These things, songs might be 300 or 400 years old for all we know on some of these pieces that we put in. But we sure have a, seem like we have a way to, what did you call it? Oh, okay.
It's a family show.
Oh, it's a family show. Well, I'll just tell you what he said last night.
I was trying to think of, like, what do I call it when we take something and make it our own? So the first thing that came out was, we Cleghornify the song.
And I said, Cleghornify? Clegsterize, more like pasteurize, you know? Something like that.
We got to work on that one.
Yeah, we probably shouldn't have shared that with you tonight.
Good thing they're recording.
Yeah, oh no, it's going out. It's going out worldwide.
Big problem. Here's a jig for you.
Jig for Alma.
Jig for Alma.
That was written just down the street from here. Dylan and I were rehearsing with another band at that time. He was, what, 17?
Yeah.
17 at that time. Well, we got there and the rehearsal had been canceled, but we didn't know it. So we were waiting for everybody and we rehearsed in a little warehouse and there was a big green dumpster out there. So we were out waiting and I said, well, we may as well work on something. So I pulled my guitar out, Dylan pulled his fiddle out, and he jumped up on top of that dumpster. So we're out in this alley, and that's the song. That's the song that came out of that. We just started jamming and playing, and it's like, yeah, that's what a lot of people think. Yeah, they think that's a big lie, but it's not.
It's true. We should have named it the Dumpster Jig.
What are we doing now?
What if I?
This is a song off our latest CD, Celtic American.
Andy, you gonna count me off?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Soundman, can I get a little of this guitar on the monitor, please?
Called Gravel Walks. That's another one of those 300-year-old Celtic fiddle tunes that we Cleghornified.
Yeah. I can't take it anymore. I've got to turn this clock around. I need a big change.
You certainly are a polite crowd.
Woo!
You got it in you. You got it in you. Did you hear this over here? He said, serve the beer. We'll all be into this. By the way, happy St. Patrick's weekend.
Taking me out.
that used to lift me up now leave me confused. One of these days the money has got to come pouring in. Maggie, oh Maggie, thanks for taking me in.
Thank you. Okay, Dylan broke a string, so he's trying to do a quick fix here or grab another fiddle. But a lot of people say, how did you guys get into this and all that kind of thing? I kind of grew up with a grandmother who played all instruments, and she was Pentecostal, and so she spoke in tongues and all those kinds of things too, scared us to death. But she could play anything. She could do it. So I kind of grew up, you know, just hearing these songs. I'm gonna tell my age here really bad. I'm kind of a late generation. I came. My grandmother was actually born in 1895, and she came to Texas in a covered wagon. So I mean, just to show you how things change. But she never quite got with it with technology. I remember she would tell us kids not to sit too close to the radio because of that radioactivity. So she didn't quite understand, you know, a lot of things, but it was kind of entertaining. I remember she didn't want us watching Star Trek because that devil guy was on there with the pointed ears. But nonetheless, anyway, one thing led to another, got married, had a son, Dylan. At a very early age, Dylan was very interested in music. I remember he came home, we had him playing viola in the school orchestra, and he came home and he said, "Dad, you got to hear this piece of music we learned today." And I went, "Oh no, it's happened. He's been bit by a song." So anyway, time went on. I was auditioning fiddle players at the house to join a Celtic rock band. And man, we had some really phenomenal guys come in and play, let me tell you. Terrible, terrible musicians. So Dylan walks in and says, "Hey Dad, I play better than these guys you're auditioning." And I said, "Do you want to do this?" And he said, "Yeah." So we had a fiddle in a closet, and we took it out and blew the dust off of it and put some electronics in it. And I called up the bass player at the time, and I said, "Hey, listen, just humor me on this. My son wants to come and to play tonight at the rehearsal, at the kind of audition, and he's been working on these songs." Well, he came in, and he picked that fiddle up, and he started playing those songs, and he started running around that room playing, jumping up and down while he was playing, and I was like,
Who is this? Who is this? On the ride home, I was driving like, where is my son? Who is this? Well, anyway, it was so good, we have never looked back. And
not to say I don't regret it.
This is what you get. All right. Well, I'm very fortunate. Back here on drums, we got Danny Rosale. Well, if you like his drumming, wait till I tell you this story on him. He grew up in that country between India and China, Nepal. You know, he lived next to those mountains that had Noah's Ark stuck in it. He was over there. Anyway, Danny kind of put a plan together and says, I've got to get to the United States. So he comes to the United States, meets a young girl, and they fall in love, and they get married. And you've been, what, married 4 years? Yeah, going 4 years. And they're just about to have a baby, by the way. Well, anyway, so he put a little ad up at a music store, and we were thinking about trying to make a change of some personnel. So I took that, tore down that little ad, and I called him from the parking lot of Guitar Center. And he said, who is this? Who is this? Where did you get this number? And I said, it's pinned up on a board. And he says, oh, 6 months ago I pinned that thing up. But anyway, he said, I'll send you a link. So he sends me a link on YouTube, and I look him up. And he's playing in a cover band doing AC/DC in Nepal. So he's out playing on this church stage, and they're doing Back in Black. But man, I could see that this guy was a player. And he made it to the U.S., and I got to tell you, he loves America. I tell you what, it is a phenomenal thing. I said, Danny, what was it like when you came to the U.S., just when you got here? And this is honestly what happened. He folded his arms, he unfolded them, and he said, it was like I was let out of a cage. I had my freedom. So for all the veterans out there, Danny recognizes that too. He says he lives in a part of the world where he sees who comes to the rescue, and it's the United States military. So I believe God's hand is in all things, and you know, Danny being with us is certainly a confirmation of that thought. Danny, give me a good groove, man. That's music talk for, hey, give me a beat.
Hey,
You guys are great. We love you guys. We're trying to at least once a week broadcast one of our rehearsals on Facebook. Has anybody been able to tune in on one of those yet?
We got one.
All right, because you'll see we rehearse in a little small studio. We need to check in on that. So it feels great to come out of here on this wonderful stage and have you wonderful people appreciate what we're doing. Thank you so much. Now, this is Dylan's latest fiddle here. He bought it on eBay. Is this the debut?
This is the debut. I've been working on it, getting it set up. Check this out, though.
Yeah, man, if it just played music when you clicked those, it'd be perfect. That's all fine and good, but I can't see the guitar.
You need some lights too.
They probably make one.
Anyway, we picked quite the song to debut this on.
Hey, listen, I want to see one thing here before we go any further. Can we get a little fog coming out of this thing?
Oh, yeah.
We got to turn down the lights and see what this thing looks like in the fog. It might look like DFW. I'm pointing at it, but no fog's coming out. Huh. Must have got busted. This one's called 9 Minutes Of. Man, how many people have seen us before? 9 Minutes Of. There you go. You know how long this song is?
It's about 10 minutes long.
He's all about that. Thank you. Cleghorn on the fiddle.
And that one's called 9 Minutes of... Woo!
Well, I guess we've got time for what, two more?
Yeah.
Can we do two more?
We can stop now and have one of those fake encores and then come back out and play.
Oh yeah, what are we waiting for? Yeah! Well, then you're gonna really love this next one. If you like those. The night's coming to an end. Kinda gives me the blues, you know what I mean? Fortunately, I've got Danny. Get me out of this, Danny.
Thank you.
What's a cat's favorite dessert? Mice cream sandwiches. You may not be laughing now, but just before you go to sleep tonight on that pillow, you'll think of that one and you'll start just laughing and laughing and laughing and have the sweetest dreams you ever had in your life. You just can't make stuff like that up on the spot. Yes, you can. How you feeling good? I said, are you feeling good? How you feeling great? How you feeling green? How you feeling? Woo, 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 woo! Played perfect all night, and then he does something like that. Never know. You know why you're feeling so good? Why, John? Well, I'll tell you why. Because they're young, free, and Celtic.
say thank you to the man for every day.